Something is coming out of this.
See, our God is a specialist. He's a master at taking conditions to move us from one place or position to another. He's a master of using conditions to propel us into a place, into a plan of action. He's a master of using conditions as a vehicle for our deliverance. There's a woman in Luke chapter number 8, a woman with the issue of blood. It was her issue that caused her to get in depression. There was a man born blind from his mother's womb in John 9. Oh my God. And his disciples had a question. You know how it is. Whenever anything happens to a believer or the saints of God, we always think it's sin. And his disciples asked, Jesus, is this, did this boy sin, or did his parents sin that he was born blind? Jesus had to correct them. And he said to them that this was neither one of them sin, but that the works of God.
All right. Yeah.
In Luke 17, who sought the face of Jesus, that they would be healed. And Jesus only spoke one word to them. He said, go show yourself to the priest. And the Bible records that as they went, they were healed. Oh, my God. Anybody pray with me tonight? And so we find Elijah down at the brook of Cherith. And the Bible says God had sent him there. Oh my God, but that was a drought. And the Bible records that the brook dried up. And God said to Elijah, get up from where you are and go to Zarephath. For I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee. I want to remind you again, your condition is not your conclusion.
All right.
In Zarephath, there's a single mother raising a son, gathering sticks to prepare her last meal. Hopelessness and despair was her mindset.
You're right about
her retirement money was lost through the greed of Wall Street. She had taken her last withdrawal from her 401k plan. In the midst of her tears, while she's preparing her last meal, she takes a pen and she begins to write her and her son's obituary. She entrusted her last remains, her final remains, into the care of Willie Watkins' funeral home. But just in the nick of time,
yeah!
And let me tell you, people of God, all we really need is not another precedent. We don't need another law. We don't need another commandment. We don't need another amendment. All we really need is a word from God. All we need is a word from God. And I came all the way from Marietta, where it's better to be greater, where it's greater.
Look at it.
To tell you that your famine is not final.
All right.
The Bible says that this woman, she was on the verge of dying. She had concluded that death was her only alternative. But the man of God, thank God for man of God.
All right.
Speak the word unto us in dry times, in dark times, in famine times, in drought. Look at your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, you may have cried in it.
You may have cried in it.
But you won't die in it.
But you won't die in it. All right.
You may have cried in it. You may have had the divorce. You may have had bankruptcy. You may have had foreclosure. But you will not die.
All right.
He says in Psalms 35, verse 5, and the B clause, weeping may endure.
For a night.
It may endure. For a night, but short. Coming in the morning. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, it's almost morning time.
It's almost morning time.
Paul said it this way. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us, for the earnest expectation of the creature waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. Is anybody praying with me tonight? It also says in
Yes!
Light afflictions, with his much wild moments, working for us, a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. While we look not at the things which are seen, but the things that are not seen. For the things that are seen are temporal, but the things that are not seen are eternal. The Bible lets us know. I want to just encourage somebody as I take my seat. Cast not away your confidence, which have great recompense of reward. For ye have need of patience, that after you have done the will of God, you might receive the promise. For yet a little while.
I'm waiting.
I'm waiting.
Believing.
I'm believing.
Receiving.
I'm receiving.